When you apply Generative Fill, you get three variations. Sometimes you like part of one variation and part of the other variation. You're going to love this tutorial. I'm going to show you how to combine them for the best possible image. In this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to mix and match generations. You'll see what I mean in a second. So first of all, why don't we just grab the trusty lasso tool and we're going to get rid of all these barriers. So let's just go select over here. Great, we got the first one. Hold down the shift key. We're going to select the second one. Now, for higher resolution, you're better off to do these one at a time. But that will change in time. So that's why I'm just going to hold down that shift key as adding to our selection. I'm just going to show you a technique that should last a long time. I'm going to hit Generative Fill, and now I'm going to click Generate. Let's see what we've got. There's the first option, the second option, and the third option. So what I like is the left-hand side from the first generation, but I like the right-hand side from the second generation. So what do I do? And if you're getting any value out of this video, hit that subscribe button, turn on notifications, you won't miss any of my videos. Being a generative layer, I can duplicate this layer, Control Command J, or drag it into the little plus icon, is going to give me two versions. So looking at this top layer, I want to look at the left-hand side, which I know was the first one. So that gives me the generation I liked there. Let's hide this. And then we go to the second layer, or the first one that we created, shows me the right-hand side that I like. So now that I've done that, I can actually just merge both of these together. And I'll show you exactly how to do it. Let's choose the mask of the top one. Remember, the top one, we want the left, but not the right. Now, see that mask is black and white. Where it's white, that layer is visible. Where it's black, that layer is hidden. Now, when I say hidden or visible, you know, just kind of think of it as light. When you see the white light, you know you can see it. When it's dark and black, you can't see it because of the darkness. All right, so let's grab a brush here. And I want to hide the contents of the layer on the right side, which means I want black. So let me hit the D key to reset foreground background colors. And I'm just going to just hit that little arrow or the X key. And black is now the foreground color. So I could do this with a marquee selection, or I can just paint. And notice as I paint, now I can just paint in the part that I want from that layer. So notice what I'm doing. You can choose pieces of each variation and get the exact result that you want. I hope you found this useful. Let me know in the comments underneath if you did. And by the way, I put out a new course on Generative Fill. Check out the link underneath and check out the code to get you 20% off for 1 week only. If you guys enjoyed this, hit the subscribe button, turn on notifications, and check out my other video here, which will give you an overview of Generative Fill. Until next time, I'll see you at the cafe.